All right, so today I want to talk about a five-letter word, all right? It's a simple five-letter word. And even though it's a simple five-letter word, the act of doing it, not so simple at all, right? And that five-letter word is focus. The reason why I want to talk about focus is because it can be the sole component behind who wins and who loses. See, I like to think about focus as this, right? Focus, we all operate at a default level of focus, okay? Mine might not be his might not be hers, yours might not be theirs, right? But we all operate at a default level of focus. I like to say on a scale of 1 to 10, it's probably somewhere between a 6 and a probably 8 for some people, right? So we'll say the average is a 7, to be on the safe side, right? It's a 7. On a scale of 1 to 10, our default level of focus is at a 7, which means that we're focusing, we might get distracted, we might come over here, might go over there, but then we might refocus, but then we might come back over here and get distracted again, right? But that's what it is, right? Now, as we mentioned before, right, that long word that begins with the D, distractions. Distractions are going to be there until the day we die. They were there when we first born, right? Distractions are going to be there. They're going to be there no matter what. I got kids now that are in high school, which I like to call distraction heaven, right? Because distractions are so prevalent when you're in high school. So prevalent when you're in high school, right? I had distractions when I was a freshman through a senior in high school back in 2014, and I know they got distractions now in 2021. But the question is how well you can focus and try to distract yourself from the distractions, okay? That's the golden question right there. Now, to pay particular attention to technically would be the definition of focus. I like to give my spin on everything. So I'm gonna say this. When I first got into my program here at UT, I'm studying sports psychology. The first thing they said to us was to focus on the right things at the right time. Focus on the right things at the right time. And while that may sound cliche, while it may sound catchy or cool or hip, it's not easy to do. Everybody can't do that. Everybody cannot focus on the right things at the right time because you're going to have distractions pulling at you and grabbing at you and reaching for you, right? I had a discussion earlier, right? We were talking about what's going to happen when not the negative side of distractions, but the positive side of distraction come. I like to group them into two parts, negative and positive, right? Negative meaning, oh, the haters, oh, they don't like me. They doing this, they doing that. Okay, that's the negative side. The positive side is this though. Phenomenal opportunity over here, right? Opportunity I've been waiting for, right? For my guys in high school, you see a girl and you really attracted to her, but you about to sign next year and all of your attention needs to be going to where you're going to school at next year. But then your girl over here is trying to talk to you, finally, and you've been waiting to talk to her for 3 years. What you gonna do? You gotta make a decision. You gonna choose your future, you gonna choose your feelings. I like that, future or feelings. We're gonna go with that, right? But what are you gonna do? And I'm saying this because these are real life examples in high school, right? And we all know when you reach out of high school, when you get grown, distractions, they don't add up, they multiply. You're gonna get distraction after distraction after distraction. This is real life. Real life, right? But it's about focus. Focus. Now, we've been practicing strengthening our focus for so long and we didn't even know. As kids, I'm sure, I know I did it when I was a kid, and I know everybody in my neighborhood did it. We all had staring contests, right? The staring contests were strengthening our focus and we had no idea that they were strengthening our focus, right? Because what happens during the staring contest? Two things. One, I'm trying to only look at what's in front of me. Maybe if I look at this person in the eye long enough, maybe they fold and they blink, I win, right? Or I'm trying to make sure I don't blink. I'm trying to make sure I don't blink before that specific person blinks that's in front of me, right? So it's one of those two things, but what's the main gist of the staring contest? What does it feel like? I'm literally looking at what's in front of me. My peripheral vision is almost turned off because I'm so focused on what's in front of me at the time. What's behind me, I don't even worry about. I can't even see that. What's beside me, I can't see that, right? And I use it for this. In the past, you can't do anything about what's in the past. Literally, you cannot go back and change anything you said, anything you did, what you didn't say, what you didn't do. It's in the past. Let it go, let it go, let it go. On the side, no matter who's talking to you, no matter what opportunity comes, no matter, oh, this and that, no, it's on the side. Focus on what's in front. You have a staring contest. You're having a staring contest literally with life every day in terms of your focus, okay? staring contest. Now that's one method to improve your focus. Two more. The other one who says this, and they're kind of combined, so I'll talk about them at the same time, right? You can write down where you see yourself in the future, near future. We can go short term to intermediate to long, right? Short term goals, where you see yourself, okay? I want to play here, my athletes, I want to play here. I want this grade on this assignment. I want to talk to this person for networking opportunities because I need them in the future. I want to apply to this school. I want to talk to this teacher about this specific thing, whatever the case may be, right? Intermediate, right? I want to graduate from this school. I want this job. I want to live in this city, right? I want to do this internship long term. I want to move here. I want this career, right? I want to do this, this, and that, okay? Now, what I'll have them do after they write all of that down is I'll have them roll it up in a paper hot dog style. And I have them close one eye, and through the other eye, I have them look at what they wrote. Now, here's the thing with that. You can't see anything on both sides of that paper because your peripheral vision is shut completely off. Anytime you look at something, it's like looking through a telescope or looking through a tunnel, right? Looking through something like that. You roll it up hot dog style, you look at it, you can't see anything on the outside. All you see is what's through that tunnel. That's it. And what's through that tunnel is what you wrote down, the things you want to accomplish, short term, intermediate, long, okay? Second activity I have them do is this, or to go along with that activity, is I have them write down the process that it takes for them to reach those goals that they wrote down in the first activity, okay? Whatever they wrote down, what does it take for you to achieve that? What's the process like, right? And after they write the process down, I have them circle it, write a circle around all of the process components, and they write little dots around the circle, as many as they can possibly write around the circle, little dots. Now, I'll ask him, what do those dots represent? I don't know what they represent. Distraction. That's what they represent. You have to stay within that circle. Stay within the process, okay? The things that's on the outside, don't worry about them. They're distractions. You cannot control them, okay? You can distract yourself from them, right? Only occupy your attention with what's inside that circle. That's focus. Focusing up, okay? One of my favorite books of all time, I have it on the side of me right here. It's Heads Up Baseball, Ken Revisa, okay? Ken Revisa, rest in peace to the legend, great guy, phenomenal information, worked with a lot of teams, was out in California working for a while. But Ken Revisa, he said, when was an acronym? What's important now? What's important now, okay? I wanted to tie that in before we leave, because it goes into what we first said when I made this video. I first got here to my program. They said, focus on the right things at the right time. Okay? Focus on the right things at the right time. What's important now? You focus on what's important now, you win. Apollo Sports Counseling, we out.